Hey guys, Gen Tree with you. And we're on map 3, Hungry in the Dark. So, and in this video, I'm going to be playing as Krillin, the lovely elf, and my favourite character. Heads. But I do have a lot to talk about her. But yeah, we'll do our hunt for the tomes and grimoires. With Krillin, I am using a. First class, the Waywalker, and I use dual swords because they have three shields. I prefer the daggers, but they only have two shields, and you really need that extra shield. You really do. And I was using the shade quite a bit because after the release of the game, where they seriously nerfed Krillin, which I find is really stupid, nerfing a character in a co-op game.
Leech, like, be a victim, me, please.
Everyone's complaining that she's too OP. It's good. But first, she was never OP. Oh, we have to stop him. Yeah, that's insane. I'm gonna kill this storm thing. Did the better, she was never OP. Why people was complaining? Because she was a popular character. And back then, if you wanted to play as it was hard to do.
Another dead rat ogre.
Yeah, easy
you'd
peasy.
Think it'd get dull, but I already want to.
Tall. There's a lot of them.
As I say, yeah, because people wanted to play as ever, but back then, better when you join somebody, and they had to capture you to switch. But well, now when you try and join somebody, tries to make sure you join a game that doesn't have your character selected. And the people that said she was OP were people that only ever played on recruit difficulty and not higher. Because on high difficulties, she gets wrecked so easily. Like, she is the squishiest character. She is squishier than
Here,
the mage.
Which a is that times are desperate.
Quite ridiculous.
They brought up a
shave me, peepers.
New creatures, little one.
Thank you. Yeah, so now she doesn't self-regenerate. With a standard class, which is stupid, so he does it if she's under half health, and that also counts as if you've got the grimoire. So it's half of what the main after is take grimoires.
If you have a point to make, Kluber,
so it's just like the best point in having her is that you can give her tomes of grimoires and stuff, and she can still be useful. Now not so much, because since it's on the high difficulties, if you've got grimoires, a standard enemy will one-shot her. But anyways, I'll save my rant for a little bit, because this is where the location of the first tome is. So when you get to this open room here, they want you to go where those guys are coming from, but we want to go down here. Yes. And then we want to go in here.
You're so
and
stoic.
There it is.
I could have sworn that
tome number
scratch.
One.
Look, it
hurts. Mage took it.
Of course it did.
I love it when they start playing it.
Alright. Packmaster's dead.
Yeah, screw you, Packmaster.
This way.
And the true shot doesn't. Doesn't seem to. Corbin as well that used to join the fate either. And she definitely does less damage. I mean, her damage capabilities is pretty crap considering everyone else is. I mean, everyone else could easily out damage her. And she also has less ammo now for this class, which is not good at all, but it's easy enough to get around because you've been mainly using melee, since everyone else can
face me blade to blade.
Well, like, but as like everyone else can out snipe her. I mean, she really doesn't have a standard role in this. It's just like, yeah, she's there because everyone else can.
Light leech, kill with haste, Mayflies.
Easily out range. Well, not really out range her, but they can out damage her at range, and then they can do it quicker because you have to load up. Whilst a lot of the guys just have to point and boom, there you go, it's dead, whatever it is. So she's definitely the weakest character at the moment. And I just switched to a Shade class because of how weak the Wave Watcher has become. But the alt on the Shade keeps glitching out that. Right click and push him out the way. Hard. Shade doesn't work properly because a lot of the time I end up pressing it so I can go invisible and phase through my enemies, but it just immediately disengages as soon as I use it. It's like I go invisible to try to walk through some enemies and then I'll just decal up for no reason and then I'm gonna stop doing all these enemies and get ripped apart in 2 seconds. As well as, so you can't really get behind him to take advantage of her backstabbing abilities. And not only that, in the higher difficulties, you do really not want to be separated from your teammates, because you will die very, very quickly. So then you can't really utilize her backstabbing there either, so the Shade is also a useless class, and the handmade is just pure useless because it is just shit. It really is. I mean, nobody uses the handmade class. The special ability is just a stupid little charge.
You had that! Mere fluke!
Yes. Let's see what happens. Okay, I'm going to the first grimoire here. So yeah, unfortunately for Krillium, she's my favourite. She is the weakest, and if you want to do it on high difficulty, it's best to take her part of the other four. And not have her. She's not good enough in this state. She cannot regenerate fully. She has less ammo, not able to do as good sniping as every other character. So when she come up here, come to this bridge here. Now, if the game is to be kind to us, which it's not, usually there's an explosive barrel here, which you need. But since the game wants to be an ass to me, so, no, you're not allowed to have that. So we have to go back to where we were before and get an explosive power from there. Hopefully. You play awful. Yeah, I'm just gonna ignore you guys. Okay. It's alright, my friends are coming. You can shoot him any time now, Groover.
Might not find you contemptible.
So, as you saw then, the
good in a fair fight, assassin.
The true shot ability is not very good at opening on things anymore compared to what it was.
Well, I suppose an explosive barrel in here.
No, you're gonna be a complete ass to me today, you game. Looks like it's not gonna give me a barrel. Oh no, there you go. You see, so once you get an explosive barrel from hopefully over there, where it should normally spawn, but the game says it wants to be a dick, you grab your barrel and you come down here. You come over here.
Ugh, that smell like festering flesh.
Don't set up the barrel. So you want to come to this bit here. Bugger off, bugger off, bugger off. You want to come to the right here. And then place the barrel here. Nice, you blows. Phase through that rubble. Jump up here. And there you are. A grimoire.
Potion, here.
And another horde. So I like haven't seen
an
that before.
Has never cornered.
Is it
me? Yeah, shit, I stupid assassins. Okay, I've got these talents where I should gain health if my true shot kills someone. But it looks like it's not giving me health. It looks like it's only giving me temporary health. It says health, not temporary health. So. Is that what it was before and then they changed it and not actually changed the description? Wouldn't surprise me. I thought if I had the true shot ability to give me health back, it might not be so bad.
Down here, are you all blind?
Turns out that is not the case. Because I want Brilliant to be a pile of shit. Well, anyways, let's continue. We'll come up to the second tomb. Oh, shit.
This is a waste of time.
You're free to leave whenever you want help.
Free to leave? But nowhere to go.
What do you mean?
Oh, it doesn't matter. We should press on.
Sure.
I don't
Come
want
on,
to
cop.
Die in the dark, but I certainly won't die alone.
Listen, walk back door.
And kill it. Do, coming up to the second dome. So yeah, so I'm very disappointed in what they've done with Brilliant. Because there's seriously no point in taking her at all. Okay, here's where the second tome is. So as soon as you enter this room, come here to the left, open this crate, and voila! Tome number two. Oh no, Chaos Warrior. I hit all the Chaos Warriors as well, the alloy can just, when they do a heavy attack, they'll slide across the map. So I hit you. That really is changing up, because those buggers can one shot you on higher difficulties, and they just want to just teleport across the map and hit you in the face. Oh, come on, Carl. But they might have.
Ain't that a beautiful shot?
Just deal with that hard, guys. Go, Cat, go, be free! Yeah. I like to remind people that this is Recruit and there's just a horde of Stormvermin. Right there. See, my difficulties are like, my Recruit is like everyone else's champion. It's really retarded how difficult this game wants to make it for me.
The Blightstorm is finished!
Game hates me. It's like, no, you're not allowed to have cool things.
Watch yourself!
Okay, so this is where the second Grimoire is, and there goes the cat. Being free.
Well, looks like we must
die! So you just carve your way through these weaklings. See, I know, right? The second Grimoire is here. You come up here. So as soon as you enter the room, just go up to the right here. Crouch in here, and then go up this ladder, and then you jump, and just walk over here, and boom, second Grimoire. Now we've just got one more tome to find.
I'm glad Adolf isn't here to see me use these worthless arrows.
Ow.
Never did like potions. Oh well, any port in a storm.
Oh well.
Down here.
And the third tome isn't here.
The unmistakable aroma of Rathman artifice and flame as well. The furnace!
The 100th horde this mission. So.
Attack the ratling from the flank! Rat gunners! Someone draw their fire!
Right, okay, so you need to get up on here. Jump. 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 And then you just run and jump over here, and there is the final tome. So guys, apologize for ranting about Carillion. It's just so annoying how crap she is now. And come on, dwarf, make the jump. Oh, I actually don't pick up the tome, dwarf. Off. And yeah, so I hope you found this little guide to the Tomes of Grimoire helpful for Hungry in the Dark, and I'll see you guys on the next one, or the last map of Act 1.